organizations can empower DevOps teams with the right combination of people, processes, and products. These three P's form a conceptual framework for successful DevOps. But people, processes, and products also can create obstacles to DevOps. What are some of the common bottlenecks to implementing DevOps, and how can organizations overcome them?
You cannot have success in large changes of thought if you don't adopt that across a broad scale. If it's a one-off initiative, you'll have small-scale success. That requires aligning teams across common goals, sustaining best practices, and establishing really a maturity roadmap that makes sense for that individual organization and it's tailored to their needs.
For successful DevOps adoption, a company must adapt its culture to align with DevOps objectives. Processes might also require reform through automation.
The DevOps bottlenecks as far as related to process is really software development lifecycle processes and change management processes. It's important to remove some of the manual aspects of that where you're bringing multiple resources together to get approval. And we call that continuous integration and delivery. And bringing that all together helps put the gates in place to help with that approval process to really the security network and database changes to accelerate that velocity.
Additionally, uniting DevOps adoption around company goals and objectives is key to success.
You know, I think one of the challenges that we see with organizations who are looking to navigate around products, around tools and infrastructure is maybe a focus too much on what brand or what infrastructure in general they're looking to apply to. They might get a little bit stuck in the mindset around brand loyalty and the nuances within what one organization does for effectively the same type of technology and the same type of product. When instead of focusing on the what, I think the better question is the how. How are you managing that infrastructure? How are you managing those products? Because the methodology that you're leveraging, some of the best practices that you're using, makes that choice not as relevant anymore. Because if you're managing it through one consistent process, then deciding what brand it is or A versus B option matters less in that because the outcome is the same.
Finally, outside partners can often help organizations overcome DevOps bottlenecks in people, processes, or products.
I think partners are really important in maturing a DevOps practice and access through a broad set of skill sets. Having an outside party come in, be able to speak to what is at the cutting edge, what is at the bleeding edge as far as skill sets, as far as what other organizations are adopting, and really apply some of those lessons learned and the best practices that are there for clients and helping them to evaluate where they are with a fresh set of eyes.